Look at this. Just, it is. I've got rivers running down. It's disgusting. It's been going like this for hours. Why do I not have a fire going? Like, I don't understand. Why am I even, what's the deal? Why would I be this foolish? You know what? I'm pulling out the big guns. It's cold in here. I'm not even playing around. It's just not happening. I'm not doing it. Let's go. This won't take a minute. Ah, there we go. Three and one. Oh, I like it. Daniel, son, gun, go. Son, cutting, killing, dead, bunker. Let's do it. Okay, I just made a fire. No paper, just crisscross. Oh dear. Fire! Pa-pa-pa! I bring you fire! Pa-pa-pa! All right. That arbutus, friends, when you, it's a hardwood, right? So when you fire that up, when it's completely seasoned, which this is, it's 30 BTUs. It's crazy, friends. It lights up quicker than fir, unless you're in the heartwood with fir. Done, fire.
Pom, pom, pom.
Okay, now, I need to check messages. I'll be right back.
Oh my goodness, there's a lake.
Look at this, wow. Okay, let's plug in, because I got a couple really cool projects on the go right now, friends. So friends, get this. We all know it's about profile, right? Yeah. So Josh, I would say he's kind of our new handle guy, Josh. Josh Hickory, Hicks Hickory. He's a nice fella. Him and his gal, just hardworking Americans. He's a man with a ton of great gratitude, pardon me, friends, as I am. Just for all the good things in our lives. He sent me some nice work, his handles. He sent me some nice work. Of course, Whiskey River was a big part of that because I always mention people who have given of their hearts and given of their, of whatever's part of theirs or where they come from. Just, I believe in giving kudos where kudos is needed. And Whiskey River was so kind to let me kind of run off of that platform of that nice skookum handle. Of course, I made tweaks to it. Actually, I made more tweaks to it. And I might send this back to you, Josh, to put on the lathe. I made some more tweaks with my sander. Anyways, if your handle is, let's put it this way. Here's one of Josh's. It's got good, they're thick, friends. So with a 5.5 pound axe, no, it's perfect. I'll show you what it is. Show you what happens when you put a 5.5 pound axe head on a Whiskey River or a good handle. It's this right here, and this is the end result. Boom, right there. So if you're wondering how that's gonna go for you on your axe handles, where you want you don't want your axe to lay out like this. You don't want that. Even that. Do you know what I'm saying, friends? You want in here about an inch. Two is okay. Two is okay, but you're starting to transfer more weight into the handle or force into the handle. You want that right in there. Even up there is fine. Up there is fine, right? Okay? But, oh dear, is what I'm saying to you, is oh dear. Now, have you guys got raindrops on you? You look like you do. Point being, here's one of Whiskey River's little fantastic little sons of guns, and he showed me that he's doing some work. You know, Whiskey, Brandon, I'm going to tell you something, buddy, about you. Probably something you already know about yourself. You were a good man. I asked you that. Well, let's say you sent me a couple handles and I was like, these are freaking beautiful. But there's a couple things up here that don't work that good and could be better. The handle could be better. And there you are sending me pictures of you welding and fixing and adding to your mold. Buddy, you're a smart guy listening to your customers. You are. We're in the field steady. I know you are too, but I mean, good for you. That's all I can say. And Josh is the same. It's just wonderful. So I took a bit of girth off this handle when my dear Lord, friends. So here's the deal. I got on it last night, but then my wife called me in for dinner and I didn't make it back out. Friends, I got to show you something. This came with this group of axes I bought out of Australia. And they came under the boat, took months, but they got here. And I bought a lot of them. This here, I'm afraid to say, it's got to be 3.5, maybe 3.75. It's in between 3.5 and 3.75. So you don't want a super, super big, heavy handle. It's going to transfer the weight into the handle and then into your arms. You want the weight transfer to be in the head. So I took some girth off of this handle. Is this the one? No, it isn't. That's not the one. Where is it? Or maybe it is. It's this one, you crazy bucking Billy Ray. That's funny. Here we go. It's Whiskey River. That's the one I was playing with. That's why this is going to be good. Okay, I see what's going on. I know what I did last night. I'll show you what I did, friends. This had been beaten upon. I just got to interject, and I just got to say something, friends. I'm having a freaking blast doing this. We are going into winter, and I think there's a bit of fog on the lens right now, but this is a short interjection. I'm watching myself here, and I'm literally excited. And I love making content for you folks. You know, I was watching some YouTubers that have been around a long time. And I think they're running out of content, you know, and they start doing these interesting things, just to say the least, to keep things rolling, you know what I mean? And I'm just so grateful that it's just my life. I turn the camera on and I just... my life is this. It's not that I'm not ever doing this, because this is my life. This is what I do. So I'm just, oof, right in the heart, Skis, today. I feel great, and I'm excited to make content for you. And this is a good video. This axe I'm working on right now, it's beautiful. It's beautiful, and I will use it, and I will probably take it into videos and probably sell it. But I just wanted to interject, friends, and just say I love yous all. And thank you for tuning in. Hit the freaking thumbs up and all that racket that we crazy YouTubers ask you guys to do. Do that for us here, would you? Okay, splendid. Back we go. I'm just going to show you the axe. Look at it. For starters, look at the shape. It's stupendous, okay? But that's not what I'm excited about. Look at this. Look at how big the opening is. Well, it had been beaten. So I did some work on the eye. I straightened the eye out. But look at this. I want to show you something. Look. Look at this freaking profile, friends. I'm not joking yet. It is a wicked, wicked profile. Axe-splitting beast aroni. Okay? So it's going on, this thing. And I'm making this for me. I'm going to run it like I did, Josh, with you. And that's why this... my axe program is like none other, friends. I make the axes. I take the axes out. I cut trees down. I buck it up and I split it with your axe. So that's why I don't make a ton of axes. And they are expensive. Of course they are. Have you looked at the cost of any hand-forged axes? Look at Tim's axes. Look at Liam Hoffman. Look at all these characters. Blacksmiths that make axes, whether they know a lot about axes or whether they know nothing about axes or they're learning about axes. Their axes are worth money. They're expensive pieces of equipment. So That's why I like to make mine extra, extra, extra special and put them on the videos and get out and use them and have content with them in my hands. I think it's special for the buyer. And that's why I don't make a whole ton of them, okay? Anyways, I'm rambling skins quite a bit, I know, but I'm very excited about this tool. But before I do this, I've got to put this in here. I have to put this in here like this. I don't have to, but I'm a gonna. Now this I don't think is big enough. Actually that might be exactly what I need right there. Okay, so if that's like that. There it is, right there. Right on the money. Okay, good. Check this out now. See how it's still tight, which is good. I want tight, but you can see exactly where it is on the wood. Oh yeah, good. I'm glad. Very good. We got curl on. Yeah, so we're starting to. This is actually incredible. So I'll show you what I mean by this, friends, this fit. Look. Okay. See? See how the action is happening there like that? See? Okay. You know what I mean? This is going to be a really, really amazing tool. I could go all the way with that. I could, that's actually just, it's fuzz. But I think I'm just gonna do a little thing that always helps. So watch this, look at this. How hard a guy has to hit that to get that off there. Okay. Yeah, see, that's hardly taking anything. That's interesting. I know it'll fix that. Just a little bit of power soft filing on the edges, friends. Just a chamfer, a slight chamfer. Now, if a guy wanted to, he could just go like this real quick. Okay, check this out now. Indeed, very much indeed. Watch, there it goes, right there. And I'm maintaining a nice solid fit. Yeah, there it goes. Look, we're already topping out. So that's why axe handles, friends, if you're making axe handles, there should be a slow taper from the top. I'm talking slow taper, like super slow, to slightly bit bigger here than there. If it's straight down, it's not going to work. It's just not going to work. It's going to keep going down, down, down to go right off the end. There has to be some kind of a shoulder, but I prefer a long, steady slope to a bit thicker. Oh, it's amazing the fit. The fits you get are crazy. Now, whether these ones are close. He's got these, this is interesting. I'm glad you're working on this handle, Brandon. This is gonna be, so here's the deal, look at, so there it is. I'm an inch back. And we're not on the head yet, not totally seated. We're coming down. This thing's almost ready to go together. Friends, this is going to be a very, very scary wood splitting axe. See, if that goes like that, so this means this can go like this. Oh yeah, there it goes right there. Tweak. Dead square. I'm excited, friends, for that right there. Very excited. Okay. Talk to you in a flash. You want to see something pretty cool?
will be very interesting. This is going to be a wicked little tool, actually. Okay. Now, I think what I'll do... Okay, it's getting there. Oh, wow. Holy. This, see, it's just going to be scary. I almost don't want to go any further because I like the length on this axe. Mind you, it is not going to matter. This is going to be a wicked tool, friends. I mean, do you remember that? Oh, dear. Oh, see, this. It's got the splitting profile where it's not as skinny here. It's kind of like that dandenong I made the other day, friends. Do you know what I mean by that? Where it's, I got two separate profiles that I really enjoy. One is a straight up log split, like wood splitting profile that doesn't do the old stick with the log, you know, when I, you know what I mean? As well
enjoy
as.
Enjoy the profile, my friend. Look at that stupid thing. Look at it. Good night.
But its benefits for the wood splitting are crazy. So I'm going to go after the persuader now because... Yeah, just because we need some stank. Wow. Wow. You can see the line where it went to before. And then I did some work on the head and it doesn't need to go there anymore. So that's actually lovely right there. You seen how hard I hit that, right? We are done. This gives us a 30. Hang on. Yep. A 30 inch to the top of the axe, which is actually a wicked, wicked length, friends, for splitting wood, chopping, doing all kinds of different things. You want to chop on a log, you know, like the old, you know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. See, here's what I was looking for right here. That's what I was looking for right there. That's the axe, the axiom right there. That's it. And do you know what the interesting thing about this is, friends? Do you want to know what's really cool about this? I'm going to show you. It's the fit. You see how hard I smashed that with the axe, right? You know what I mean, friends? Like, this is what I'm talking about. Tapered fit. Craziness. This handle's got sinew in it. Oh my goodness gracious. See, oh my gosh. Friends, I just, can you see it? Can you? The green? Can you see the green, friends? The green's outrageous. Straight up and down the green. Look at it. Carry the body. So, okay. Let's reach down here, and what do we pull out? Oh, what happens to be a little bit of spotted gum. My. Might keep that there. Okay, I gotta go to the sander now, friends. So I'm going to be back in a flash. This here, oh my gosh, this, see, this is going to be scary. Look at this.
Let's check it here first. Let's see what this says.
Oh yeah, see this is, you see that? Look, shaklank, right? Okay, see?
Shlunk.
Shaklank, okay? Pull that out, go like this. Oh, look at that. 2/3 down the axe, even a touch more. Okay, by me. Let's grab our freaking thing here and have a look, see poo. Oh, would you look at that? Kisho Nando, Kisho! Back in a flash. Okay, friends, let's do this now. We're putting this in here, and we're going for it. This is what we're doing. We're going for it. Now, because of that, you know what? I'm just going to ram it. I'm not worried about it. I'm not going to try and get, like, because I know the back is going to be amazing. The front, I could bring to a point. You know what, friends? Just because I'm a little bit of a perfectionist, just hang on. I'm not terribly, but I'm a little bit. Let's try that. It was just to, maybe to fill that up there a little bit when we go in. And it may. It just may do it because that's kind of the feller I am. When I'm a feller, when I be a feller. Because you're a feller, aren't you? You're bucking feller. Feller. You're a good feller, bucking. Good feller. Let's do this. Let's not horse around. Let's do it. We're going for gold on this one, friends. I'm going for gold. Do you guys want to get a close-up on it? Should I feed you guys a close-up? Because that's the kind of feller I am. Remember, I talked about that feller I was, right? The feller guy? Let's do this.
Try this on for size. What do you think about this, fellers? Try that on.
Fellers and fellettes. You never forget the fellettes. We push this like this. We grab our... Let's do it. So far, so good. Oh, heavens, yes. You guys can see that, right? It's so far in there now, I can literally do this. Look at this. See, I gotta be honest.
I don't know who you are, where you're from.
That flat, when you make that flat, don't ever forget when you're making axes. Chamfer your corners, friends, or you're going to break handles. Give me 2 seconds. I want to show you something. Okay, friends, I'm just going to show you right out of the chute. It gets me rolling in the wind, okay? You see why I did that at the top? Remember in the last couple minutes I came and did this little thing here? That's why. Because it came to a point. Look what Buck and Bonzo did. What do you want to know? Come on, friends. Look at the metals even splayed out because it was a beat up old Tassie. And this thing is now an extremely, extremely integral and scary wood. Look at profile. Oh, dear.
You know, and you put it in your, oh, see, look at that. It just wants to sit on its little home right there. Look at, oh, turn your finger, Bucket. Look at, shaklank.
So here's a tool that, in my mind, friends, this is a whipper snapper mean, like laser beam, kind of like a laser beam show. Let's do this just for a second. It's kind of dark. There's a slight bit of light left in the air, a wee bit of a light.
But not much. I bet you Ganji's got his power saws and stuff in there still. Oh, he didn't. Surprise me, young fella. Good man, Ganji. Oh, look at the moon. Hey, look at that. Shaklank. No way. We got to zoom in on that. Hang on. Just hang on. I'm putting that axe down on my freaking thing there. Look at this sucker. Who wants, look at that. Davey, All right. Enough. Enough
horsing
around. Oh yeah. See, it's we have problems. We have big problems. Oh my dear goodness graciousness. I wish it was light out, but it is not. Whoa! What the heck is that all about? Trippy. Oh dear. Oh my goodness.
Thank you for watching my videos. It sure was fun building this axe with you here tonight, everybody. Shall we grab the Wodka? A little mix of oil and varnish. Together, the togetherness makes a wonderful concoction. We might as well put on the old Wodka. Let's take this off right now so we don't forget to take it in the house with us. I always forget. I like sometimes to sing the words I'm speaking. Now, let's do this. Shaklank. Shaklonk. We make axes here at Buck and Billy Ray's YouTube channel. We like axes a lot. Axes, actually, I can almost say 1, 2, 3 times have almost saved my life now. And what I mean by that, I don't want to sound like some weirdo nerdo, but I am. Let's not mistake in it. When I was a young man, they were there for me to, I guess, give me something to do. My hands. I was a very, very, not a schoolboy. And they gave me the outlet. Friends, they were an outlet for me, axes. So I've always used them. Now, they came back and they got me again and saved me again when I went off on a horrible tyrant in my younger days, when I was able to, you know, when you become of age and you're allowed to go to the bars and all that stuff. Well, I didn't stop going. I kept going, and it became a problem for me. And that wasn't good. That wasn't good for anybody that was around me at that particular time. So the axes, once again, they came through for me there. The bush, right? Firewood, to be honest. Axes, power saws, they were there for me again. Now, the axe, now I'm actually, it is here again for me, because I'm now building an axe called the wood bullet. And I'm pretty freaking excited about it. Kind of scary, actually. Puts a real nice finish on it. Oh boy, is that ever nice. See? It softens the corners. See that? Rounds them out. And not only that, I knocked down the tip. The toe, because as it comes through the wood, it'll bash that wood up if you don't straighten that out.
Hello, my name is Mr. Axe. I'm very aerodynamic to go through any species of wood. Good night.
Video uploaded. Check. Coffee? Timmy's? Arr, mateys. Check. Friends, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm packing up saws, putting on some climbing gear, and going to cut down a couple trees beside a house. 100-foot fir trees. You know, what are you going to do? You got to make a living somehow. Friends, I'm in a good mood. What can I say? I just wanted to end off the video by saying something, because that's the last little blurb I did on that axe, and I can't wait, and I'm going to use it today. So that'll be in probably tomorrow's video. Rock on, friends. Be kind.